Hello and welcome to GRE Mnemonics, video number 28. A quick recap of our previous video. A giant fish had swallowed teacup and was having hiccups. A syringe manufactured by a milk powder company was used to treat the fish. The injection was given under the skin. As an effect, all the fish laid down to deep, calm sleep. The fish got transported to a dam on a goggle. Here, the fisheries minister gave a speech. He quoted from stories and manipulated the issue for vote bank politics. Children playing nearby overheard the story in the speech. Meanwhile, some of the fish ended up in Burj Khalifa Hotel, whose design was already finalized in an ancient game known as Lagori or Seven Stones, which the kids enjoyed. All right, so let us learn and understand today's set of words using this short story. Broccoli and Leo were having few misunderstandings. They were imbroglio. Leo the lion sneaked inside Himba tribe's brewery. There were coffee stains all over his shirt. The tribesman had a selfless concern for his pet bird. He named her True Is Hum. He saw a deer licking his wound in an abandoned zoo nearby. The tribesman offered a big lime on a limitless table. So let us understand the words individually. Imbroglio, clue, broccoli and Leo had misunderstandings. Imbroglio means a misunderstanding attended by ill feeling, perplexity or strife. So visualize imbroglio, broccoli and Leo having misunderstandings. The present imbroglio between the exhibitors and artists, producers and directors should be sorted out amicably within the legal frame. This example presents a peaceful solution to the misunderstandings between the exhibitors and artists. Imbrew, clue, in the brew. Imbrew means to wet or moisten. Imbrew has Germanic origin and is related to broth. Visualize the Himba tribe's brewery where the lion sneaked and has got coffee stains all over his shirt. Since the fabric was a white color, it was difficult for the housekeeping boy to not imbrew his clothing with stains. This example is about a housekeeping active boy. And it was very difficult for him to not get these stains on his shirt. Altruism. True. The bird was named Truham. Altruism means benevolence to others on subordination to self-interest. It also means behavior of an animal that benefits another at its own expense. Reciprocal altruism is often seen, which makes V-shaped flocks of birds possible. So visualize altruism. The bird was named Truham. It means selfless. Most health professionals are motivated by altruism and concern for patients' best interests. In this example, we get to know that some health professionals are motivated by altruism, that is benevolence to others and concern. Derelict, clue, deer licking its wound in an abandoned zoo. Derelict means left and abandoned, negligent in performing a duty. has Latin roots, which means abandoned. Visualize a deer licking its wounds in a derelict zoo. The yards are full of derelict cars, broken down furnitures, sofas with the stuffings bursting out. This example, we get to know about the yard being full of derelict or abandoned items. Illimitable. Clue, limitless lime table. Illimitable means without limits in extent, size, or quantity. Visualize a huge lime on a limitless table. The human capacity for doing good is illimitable. In this example, we get to know that a human being's capacity for doing good is limitless. Time for quiz. Do you remember the word which means to wet or moisten? Do you remember the meaning for the word imbrue? Do you remember the word as well as the meaning associated with this mnemonic? I hope you got all three of them right. In case you haven't, feel free to watch the video again. Let us know about your experience here. Till we meet next with our next set of GRE words. Thank you.